My brothers and sisters, good evening, good evening. Welcome to the prayer line tonight. Welcome to the prayer line. We thank God again. It's another Thursday night that we can gather here tonight again and eat at the table of the Lord. So I say it again, good evening, good evening. Welcome to the prayer line. God bless you. We are now at the end of the year. We thank God for keeping us, for protecting us, for blessing us, for feeding us, for promoting us, for everything that God has done for us. And we thank him that we are still healthy. We thank him that he's protecting us against what is going on around the world. And I pray to God that to my brothers and sisters, to the body of Christ, that the Lord will come to protect us, that no evil shall befall us, that we should continue to look at the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ and continue to look unto heaven for our help from the Lord God. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We're coming to the end of the year. So tonight, as we start, so we have to bless the Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. I bless his holy name. We bless you, Lord, our God, forever and evermore. Blessed be thy glorious name, which is exalted above all blessings and praises. My Lord and my God, the great Jehovah, the King of kings, the Lord of lords, the God of all gods, the Ancient of Days, the Lily of the Valley, the Rose of Sharon, the God of the spirits of all flesh, the Lord of hosts, we bless you. The great I am that I am, God of Israel and the Holy One of Israel, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Shalom, El Kankanam, El Adonai, the Lord God of creatures, the Word of God, Yeshua HaMashiach, Yeshua HaMashiach, Yeshua HaMashiach, Lord Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, the eternal God, the only wise God, we bless you. God the Father, Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we bless you. The brightest morning star, we bless you. Thou art a great God, ready to pardon and gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. We thank God and praise his holy name. We thank him for bringing us to the end of this year, to December 2021, to the last month of the year. Soon, a couple of weeks from now, we'll be entering January 1st, 2022. And we thank God for all the things, the mercies, the goodness, the protection that he has shown to us throughout this 2021. So, and very soon we shall be witnessing 2022. He has kept us, fed us, protected us, and blessed us. Thank you forever and ever and ever more, our mighty, mighty and gracious and powerful God. There is no God before him. There is no God with him. There is no God after him. He alone is God Almighty, and we love him. Hallelujah. So for tonight, for thanking our God as we thank him every day, as children of God, we don't wait until one day per year to set aside to thank our God. No, no. For Christians, those who are born again and have the Spirit of the living God, we thank God every day. We are required to thank our God every day, every morning, the first thing in the morning for God to hear our voice. So we are required to thank our God every day. We don't have to wait for a day per year to thank God. No. We thank God every day because he is our God. He's the one that keepeth us. He's the one that fed us. He's the one that protect us from our enemies, you know. So we have to thank him. So good evening, my brothers and sisters. And as I said always, it is always a pleasure when we gather here. Today again is December 2nd, Thursday, December 2nd, 2021. We're coming to the end of the year. So God bless you. So now, before we start tonight, our sisters will be leading us in worship, in praises, and sharing the word with us tonight. So let us just go in a little bit of prayer. But I would just thank you for tonight, oh God. We give you all the praises and the glory and honor. We love you, Lord God, because we know you loved us first, oh God, and you loved us into existence, oh God. You loved us so much that you sent your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who went to the cross and laid down his life for us that we might become righteousness of God. Father, we thank you, Lord, for the pain, the humiliation, the disgrace that our Lord Jesus Christ went through at the cross. He was given vinegar as water to drink. He bled, all his flesh torn. He suffered a lot. They put a thorn of crown upon him. And he was crucified because of our sins, O God. But by the power of your Holy Spirit, O God, he was resurrected on the third day. And that is the basis of our Christianity. That is the basis of our fellowship with you. That is the basis of being born again, because we know, Lord God of Israel, that that same Spirit that resurrected Jesus Christ on the third day, if that Spirit be in us, whether we be dead or alive, we shall be resurrected. We shall be caught up into the clouds with him on the day that our Lord Jesus Christ shall appear in the cloud. So, Lord Father God, that is the basis of our religion, oh God, of Christianity, oh God, because Christianity is knowing God through Lord Jesus Christ. Why religion is knowing God through men? But we are required to know God through you, oh God, because you gave your only begotten Son that went to the cross, that was made a sin for us, that we might become righteousness of God. Every righteousness of man, every holiness of man is filthy rag before you, because no man can please you in the flesh. We are righteous because before you, O God, because of the work of our Lord Jesus Christ that he did for us at the cross of Calvary. Otherwise, all men are filthy rag. All the religious righteousness, the religious holiness, they are all filthy rag. They stink before you, O God. But we become righteousness when we are hidden in Christ in you, Lord God of Israel, through the precious blood of Jesus Christ that was shed at the cross of Calvary. So, Father, we thank you, Lord. We know, Lord, Father God, that he was resurrected on the third day and ascended unto heaven on Mount Olive in Israel with his holy angels. And he's seated on the right hand of power and is a soon coming king. He is a priest forever in the order of King Melchizedek. And Lord Father God, we know, Lord Father God, even as he said in the book of Revelation chapter 1, he said, I was dead, but I am alive. I am alive. I am alive again. I was dead, but I am alive again. And I have the keys of hell and of death. That I am a soon coming king. So Lord Father God, we know that he's alive forever and ever. And he cometh soon, oh God. It doesn't matter whether we die before Lord Jesus Christ come back, or we're alive before he comes back. It does not matter. What matters is that if we die in Christ, we know when he comes back, the dead in Christ shall be resurrected first, then those who are alive at his coming. So, Lord Father God, we thank you, Lord, for what you have done for us. That is the love of God, the true love of God. So, Lord Father God, no one can love us the way you love us, oh God. And you are the only one that can be trusted. And we put all our trust in you, oh God, because you are the only one that will not fail us, oh Lord Father God. So we thank you, Lord, for everything that you have done, even as you have protected us, all what has happened throughout this year, Lord Father God. We are still alive. We are still breathing, oh God. We are still waxing strong, oh God, in your spirit, oh God, in your word and in your power, oh God. It's only you that can keep us. We don't put our trust in no government. We do not put our trust in no people. We do not put our trust in no friends. We do not put our trust in no relatives. We put our trust or church members. We put our trust or we do not put our trust in any pastors or bishops or pope or priests. We put our trust in you, O Lord God of Israel, because you are God who have delivered us. Where were they in the days of our darkness? But you, Lord God, have shined your glorious light into our darkness, and you make our darkness to become light. You are God who have forgiven us our multitude of sins and iniquities. When we came to you, Lord Father God, you washed away our sins in the blood of Jesus Christ. So, Lord Father, we thank you, Lord. We bless you, Lord Father God, because we have no one else beside you. The days that cankerworm, caterpillar, and lukewarm, and palmer worm has eaten, you restore it back unto us, O God. You are God full of abundance of mercies and loving kindness and goodness, O God, who is ready to pardon, O God. We love you, Father. We thank you. We bless you. Spirit of the living God, the Spirit of our Lord Jesus Christ, our comforter, our mentor, our teacher. Spirit of the living God, may you come to help us to mature the fruit of the Spirit. It is only you that can help us to mature the fruit of the Spirit. May you come to circumcise our hearts, of any junks in our hearts that on daily basis that we may look more and more and more and more like Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit. Help us to mature the fruit of the Spirit. Without you, we cannot do nothing. Without you, our Christian journey is wasteful and useless without Holy Spirit in us. So Lord God of Israel and Holy Spirit of the living God, if there's anywhere that we have grieved you, forgive us. May you never depart from us, Holy Spirit. We need you, Holy Spirit of the living God. Help us to manifest the gifts of the Spirit. For freely those gifts are given to us, and freely it shall be given. Your gifts are not for sale. Your gifts are not for prostitution. Your gifts is to give. Freely it is given, and freely shall be shared with everyone. So, Holy Spirit of the living God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord God of Israel, God the Father, Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We thank you, we bless you, we worship you, we magnify your name, we glorify your name, we exalt you, and we honor you, O God. For you are glorious, you are worthy of praises, you are worthy of being blessed from us, O Lord God. We thank you, Lord. You are God that does not look unto the hands of men. What you require of us is for us to love you, to obey you, to keep your commandments, to walk in your righteousness and holiness, to keep your laws, your statutes, and your commandments, that it may be well with us, that we may eat the good of the land, that we may prosper, that when we die, that we may stand before you and we may enter into your kingdom. So we thank you, God the Father, Christ the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Even as your daughter come tonight to preach your word, O God, Minister Margaret, I pray, Lord Father God, even as she preach this word tonight, that your Holy Spirit will speak through her, O God. Give her meal for us for tonight that will eat, that will change our lives, O God. We lift her up before you, O Lord Father God. May you come to bless her, may you come to use her mightily. And we thank you, Lord God of Israel, for what you have been using her to do on this prayer line. We thank you, Lord, for the praises, the worship, and sharing of your word that has blessed us. Bless those on WhatsApp, bless those on YouTube, O God. May you come to anoint the word, O God. Help us to receive your word, O God. May the blood of Jesus Christ cover her, Father God. May you bring her to those places that you have promised her. And we know, your Lord God, that your word can never come back void unto you. Your word always prosper in what you have sent it to do, O God. Because you are a great Jehovah, a God that cannot lie, that has never lied, and will never lie. So, Father God, we thank you, Lord. We bless you. We thank you for our brothers and sisters. We thank you for what you have been doing in the life of individual. We thank you for all the testimonies for this year, oh God. All the miracles, all the answer prayers that you have been doing for this year. We thank you, Lord, and the previous years, oh God. Even what you have done at the evangelical ministry, oh God. Trips, oh Lord, Father God. We thank you, Lord, Father God, because it's all about you. It's all about your name. It's all about your glory. We are just vessels of honor unto you, oh God. We are just servants unto you, Lord, Father God. We do nothing. Everything that is done is through your power. So, Father, we thank you, Lord, even as she preached the word tonight. May it be an anointed word in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Bless my brothers and sisters. In Jesus' name we pray tonight. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you. We bless your holy name. We thank you. We honor you, Lord. There is none like you, Lord. Hallelujah. We give you all the glory, all the honor, all the adoration. Father, even as we come before you this evening, we bow ourselves before you. We submit ourselves unto the power of your Holy Spirit. We ask, Lord, that we continue to decrease so that you may increase in us, Lord. Lord, we resist the devil, and we know he shall flee away from us. Father, we thank you for this glorious day. This is the day that you've given us, Lord. We rejoice and we are glad. We thank you, Lord, that you are the one who had woke us up this morning. And, Lord, you have kept us in the right mind, Lord. We thank you, Lord, even this evening, as usual, that you give us this platform, this opportunity, that we are nothing, Lord. Lord, it is by your graces, by your mercy, that we can come before your throne room, Lord. Lord, to even bring our hearts before you. We humble ourselves before you. We ask, Lord, that you take full control by the power of your Holy Spirit, Lord. Lord, even as we come tonight, Lord, to worship you, to give you thanks and praise, to bring adoration, Lord, to lift your name on high, Lord, for we know all that we have, all that we do is for your glory. Father, we ask when we are done, Father, that the glory will go back to you and only you, Lord. Father, we are only a vessel. We ask, Lord Jesus, that you may use us in any way that you see fit to use us tonight, Lord, for your glory, for your kingdom. Let your name only be exalted, Lord. The name that is above all names. You say that the name of Jesus, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. We declare and decree that you are our Lord. We have no other God but the only true and living God. And we thank you, Lord, for loving us first so we can love back on you, Lord. Receive our adoration tonight. Receive our praise tonight. Receive our gratitude tonight, Lord. In the name of Jesus that we have prayed. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah.